Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all are safe, healthy at home, staying back at home, because now it is a very dangerous period, the lockdown period. All of us should stay home and stay safe. We should abide by all the rules which is given by the government, as well as at home we should study a little bit to continue our studies. I, Arundhuti Ray, your Arundhuti ma'am, here will be teaching you science from your book Inspired Science number 3. We will follow the syllabus and go accordingly. So our first chapter is living and non-living things. We are going to discuss about it elaborately. Though most of us know, you all know, even most of us know that what are living and non-living things. But still, in this chapter, we are going to study about it in details. The characteristic features of living things, those who are not seen in the non-living things, and what is their basic difference. All these will be discussed and explained to you elaborately in this chapter. In this chapter, beginning only, we see that there are pictures of cranes and in the introduction. So as we know, the cranes can move about, they give birth to the small ones, they lay eggs, they eat, they breathe. So the cranes are the examples, or very good examples of living things. At the same time, we find the stones and other things, the dry grasses around, which are non-living things because they don't breathe, they don't move about, they don't eat, etc. So that is the concept we get from the picture. Next, now we see there are many things around us. They are the natural things. Some of them are natural, while some of them are made by man. That is artificial. They are called artificial. So two types of things we see around us. Some of them are natural, some of them are humans. Made by the humans. That is artificial. So amongst the natural things, we find both the living and non-living things in the natural things. Living things are the plants, the trees, the birds, the animals, the insects, the germs, and so on. Whereas non-living things is the moon, the sun, the sky, the chair, tables, and others. So, but most of the non-living things which are made by human beings, they are called the artificial things. So now we will discuss about the difference between the living and non-living things. According to their characteristics or the criteria, the difference will be discussed between the living and non-living things. First of all, living things need to breathe. All the living things take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. They take in the pure air and give out the impure air, which contains more of carbon dioxide. There are different organs of breathing of different animals, different living things. For example, human beings and most of the mammals, they breathe through their nose. The insects like cockroaches, then the grasshoppers, they have small holes by the side of their body which are called their spiracles, and it is through their spiracles that they breathe. The fishes breathe through their gills. Plants also breathe through the small holes under their leaves. Plants breathe through their small holes under their leaves. That is called the stomata. So these are the various criteria of the various organs of the living things to breathe.